Welcome to the Janome Studio. My name is Ann Hine, and today we're going to talk about the knife feature in the Artistic Digitizer software. This is a project that I did earlier where we took a letter and we split it, and there'll be a link in the description so you can go to the video for this one so you can see how I actually did the split letter for there. But I used the same knife feature over here when I did this honeycomb with the bees on it. The honeycomb actually came from the Janome 15,000, and it was very rectangular. So I cut different parts of the honeycomb off and reattached them in other areas around here to make it more organic looking. And then I added the bee, and the bee, I believe, is in the program, and you can take the bee and make it different sizes, so it looks like you have little bees and big bees on your hive. So let's get started. When I started the embroidery for my bee jacket, it didn't start like this. I actually stitched the hive and three of the bees first, and it looked like this. So that's what I got done first, and after I got it on there, I thought, ooh, I don't really like that, and I'm gonna have to make some changes and add some things to it, just to make it look less like I just slapped an embroidery on my jacket. So I had to get a little creative. So let me tell you first how I got this part done and then where I went from there. I started this project using this design, and this hive design is from the MC15000, the Janome Memory Craft 15000. And at the time I was using the 550E, so this is the hoop that it's in. And when I got it in here, I knew it's not going to fit in here. So I was going to have to clip it away. Anyway, so I came in here and used my drawing tool for digitize outline shape. Left click, right click, end shape. Go to selection and select it all. And then we go to my favorite tool when we right click and knife. Knife will clip sections away for you. We'll clip your embroidery. So I went in here and this part gets clipped away, and I could just delete it. And then there are some little pieces right in here that can be selected and deleted, or you can select and delete them right from your sequence window too. So once I had all those done, I brought my bees in. It looked like this, and I stitched it on, and that's when I decided, yeah, I got to do a little bit more to this. So what I did was, to get this, what I did is I used my base design and I clipped away parts to make these extra parts and put them on, and I added some extra bees. So to do that, I took a copy of this hive. So I'm going to right click on there, copy, right click again, and paste. Then I could just grab this and bring it over here. Now I like to work without any grid lines for this project and without my hoop on there, because I went up to view and you can turn your grid and your hoop off here. And then I do like a nice white background, and you can change your background colors under fabric. And I like the fabric non-normal, so it's nice and white, so I can see it a lot better. But everybody has their preference, so pick what you like and work the way you like to work. So this top section I know is loose because I clipped it away before, so I'm going to have to ungroup here and then take this top section. So this is the part I brought up here, and I tried to put it in different places and see what I liked, and I didn't quite have it where I wanted it, and realized, oh, if I flip this design, I think, I want it to curve around a little bit. So I think that would be better. So up here in my toolbox, as long as my piece is selected, I can click on mirror and it turns my design, flips it for me, and then I can put it in place. Once I got it in place, these little pieces out here, these little extra pieces, I use the knife tool again to delete those. So I'll show you that quickly. Select digitize outline shape, left click, right click, end shape. I could do this one, left click, right click, end shape. Selection tool, select all of it, Now when you select all of it and you do right click knife, it's only going to clip one of those, and then you'll have to select again and do knife, and it'll clip the other one. So now both these parts are separate pieces and I can delete them off of here. So that's how I got that piece ready. And then once it was the shape I wanted it to be, I brought it in here and placed it on the hive like so. And then to cover up any joins that maybe I didn't think they were going to look good, I brought the bee in and laid it on top of there like this. And we're going to rotate this around a little bit so it covers. So let me take the gold one out of the way since we don't need it, so you can see. So there's the bee, and he can be placed there, he can be enlarged or whatever you need to do to kind of cover that up. Now when I was placing this, I was using the MC15000, and I really like the apps that go with that, so I used the AccuSetter app to place it on there. And then in AccuSetter you can actually move the bee around a little bit more, or I could go to my edit screen and move the bee a little bit too to put him right where I wanted him to be. Or you can add him last afterwards too. So once I got that one done, I went and worked on the bottom one. And this little section, so I just looked at different sections and made some clips and dragged pieces over. This little piece I'll show you came from this section right here. And then he was sitting right back there. So that's where that is. And then I added a bee on top of there so we'd have a cover for the part right here in case this was a little bit not looking so great. And again, I found a little piece over here that I liked and I just used it and added it on right there. So once I got this view of all my pieces so I could see them, I went ahead and selected different groupings and put them in separate hoops. So this section here with the bee I had, I put it in another hoop. There it is. And this way I can print a template. So if you don't have any apps to work with, or you don't have the cloth setter, and you can use the cloth setter with this too, or you're just using the grids that come with your hoop, what you want to do is take your design like this now, go to print, and then in the print function, here's my design. It has all the information about my design, even down here, the different steps, stabilizers down here, all of that, and my centering arrow is in here, but I don't need all this extra stuff. So I can come over here to the dialog box and do design only. And then I do want my start point because I do want to be able to place this. So I would print this out and trim it close. And then I would take it to my jacket and lay it on my jacket, either pin it or tape it in place. And then when I lay my jacket, I would hoop some stabilizer, lay my jacket over the hooped stabilizer, and using the grid from my hoop, the centering grid, I would align the center of the grid to the center of my crosshair. And then it would be perfectly placed on there. Take it to my machine, and then I would stitch it out. Now, if you placed it and then you get to your machine and you get the hive part stitched and it's not quite where you want it, you can take your design into your edit screen and move your bee or bring the bee back in. Don't stitch the bee yet. You could bring the bee back in and place the bee anywhere you like to. All right, I hope you like this project. I'm Ann Hine, and we have included my email address, so if you have questions on the software or the project, you can email me. We also put in TechSupport's email, so if you have software issues, you would contact TechSupport for that. So thank you, everybody. Hope you enjoy the project.